Hi, welcome back on my channel. That's Dorota Palicka, international nail artist and educator. And today I have prepared a great design for you, a little bit of fun with the transfer foil. We will use two different techniques to achieve that look. Have a preview of that in here. I hope you really like this colorful design. If you do, let me know in the comments below. I'm looking forward to reading them all. So let's start. That's the design I have prepared for you today. So nice and summery, and I show you how to create it. So normally I use the tips on the stands, but for transfer foil it's a no because I do struggle too much. So I find it is much easier to do it like this. On the client, obviously this problem doesn't exist. We are going to use the transfer foil gel and apply it on the entire tip because we want to get the full coverage. Okay, nice and thin layer. Make sure you cover all the places where you want the gel to be and the transfer foil to be, and then let's cook it. We are going to cure it for 60 seconds. Okay, and do the same on the next tip. Let's paint it. Cover everywhere and then cure 60 seconds. The foil which we'll use comes in a box of 10 different designs. You can also get them from our website as well, and I'm going to play with those ones. So I will cut out this color, or maybe not. I love this one, the blue, and let's do it blue and pink and purple. So just cutting out what I like. And now we can transfer it. So I like the words love, and I'm going to put it kind of in the center. Press it down and then wrap everything nicely in there. You want to wrap the design really well. And once you start feeling it is starting coming off, you can start taking the transfer foil off. Okay, so I can see it is lifting away, so I can start just lifting it up. And it's so much easier when we've got the solid support for it. That looks absolutely beautiful. Let's do it the same on the other one. And I think I want this one. All you need, or the bubbles, oh gosh. Let's place it there. Again, just place it there and then wrap it in. This is so much quicker, guys, if you have seen me doing the full foil coverage. So this is how you do it on the client, because obviously the tip doesn't move. But when you've got the stand, it's just a nightmare. Okay, once you see it starts lifting, you can just peel it away. That looks really pretty even on its own, like really, really pretty. But now we are going to go and play with the next step. So I'm going to use different foil gel, because this is also a foil gel, but this one, I like it for like a precise work, because it doesn't run, it's not as watery as the other one. And we are going to paint some leaves since it is a summertime. So dew liner brush. And I like this this loaf in there. Let me just clean my brush. And then paint the leaf. So I want the leaf to have some empty space so the design is showing through it as well. So let's do the outline first of that leaf. It is really wiggly. Like wiggly leaf. And then you want to paint some eyes in there. Like an empty spaces, holes. Start with those empty spaces first. Some of them going to be quite large. Okay, and then we are going to start coloring this, the rest of the design into the black. First of all, painting with the black gel is easier than doing it with the clear gel. Just because you can see it, what you're doing. Add another hole in there. Try to distribute the product even-ish because the product needs to cure like quite even, so the foil is going to transfer even as well. Okay, so now I'm just distributing the product so I don't have like an too much somewhere or too little. And we've got those nice leaf with the holes in it. I want to do a little leaf here as well with some hole in it. Okay, that's me happy with that. I'm going to cure it. Slow curing motion for 60 seconds. On this one, I will paint a slightly different leaves. So I'm picking up like a blob of the product on my brush. I don't want to cover this bubble. I think it's so pretty. I will paint some leaf in here. So clean the brush, pick up the blob, press it hard, and then drag it. Is it too much light, cameraman? I can place it at the... Okay, that's the 60 seconds gone. I have to just leave this tip the way it is and transfer the other foil so it doesn't overcook. We are going to use some gold transfer foil now. Got actually some piece in there. Place in between my fingers and just hold it there. Hold it like so you get it properly and then pull it out. And then do the same on the bottom. So hold it and then pull it out. Okay, place this one on the side. And let's finish this one. I've got too much product on my brush and I feel like I'm not going to paint it nice, so clean it. So we've got a different type of leaf and then another one in there, but without of covering the bubble. It's actually fun to do those designs. Because the background looks so pretty, you can just do lots of different options on top of it when it comes to the leaves. Again, 60 seconds. Now I'm going to add some detail into this leaf. So using the same gel, I'm just painting like a thin line inside, which is a leaf vein. And then some lines on the side. And then freeze it. The other one is a couple seconds longer. So clean my brush, hide it from the sun. So 8 seconds longer, and then I can transfer this foil there. That's it ready. Oh no, guys, I have touched it by the mistake, and now I might have the difficulty. So let's do it. Oh. Hold it. I'm going to hold it a little bit longer because I have removed some of the inhibition layer, which I needed it. That's it. And then clean the mess which I have created. Oh, one more. What happens is, like, you can see it, there are some shiny places, like, and there is a tiny bit of the transfer foil there. Usually you want to use a clean piece each time to get a better results, so you don't get dirty pieces of the foil sticking into everywhere, like it did on my design. Top coated. So top coat everywhere. And let's cure it. And we can also top coat this one. Actually really like this one because you can clearly see the writing, and doing the writing a freehand, that would take quite a long time. So playing with the transfer foil is a big time saver. Now let's cook them, and then I can show you the final look of the designs which we have created. This transfer foil definitely goes to bin. I cannot use it anymore because things like the ones in the video would happen. Okay, the first one is ready. I can place it there. And the other one as well. Actually, the blue should be in the middle. Let me do the blue in the middle. That goes well now together. Yeah, nice and pretty. Also quite easy as well to do it. I will show you in the different angles so you can guys see it. I'm sending you glittery hugs, and bye for now.